have another video. So this is another, it's a kind of, you know, it's an inspirational message, so I want to share it with you here. So I think that it's going to be benefiting many of you that are watching my channel, okay, or that will watch. Alright, so if you're new here, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Worshipper's Heart TV. On this channel, I share topics on faith, spiritual growth, spiritual maturity, inspirational messages, and whatever else the Lord leads me to share. And so in today's video, I want to talk to you guys about another thing that the Lord's been sharing with me. And I'm not too sure what I'm going to title the video as yet, but maybe it's Mount Up or Run or something like that. I'll let you know what I mean. So if you have your Bibles, let's get straight into scripture, okay? So in 1 Kings chapter 18, if you don't know the story, Elijah, you know, he was, Ahab, and you know, Jezebel and Ahab, they were like, you know, they hated him, right? They called him a troublemaker in Israel. They said he was the biggest troublemaker, and Ahab wanted to catch him a long time because you know, Elijah was a man of God. He was doing great things, and of course they didn't like him because Ahab, you know, served Baal and all these false gods. So the Lord was literally using Elijah a lot, and Ahab hated him, and he was after him. He wanted to kill him all the time because he spoke to him and told him that the Lord was going to kill him, you know, for what he did to Naboth and, you know, all of that. So follow with me. So in 1 Kings chapter 18, right, after everything had done, the false prophets were put to shame, and you know, the people started to honor God again and say God is the real God, because all the false prophets, like, none of them, they were crying out. And hold on, let me read the part for you. At noon, Elijah started making fun of them. Pray louder. He is a god. Maybe he's daydreaming or relieving himself, or perhaps he's gone on a journey, or maybe he's sleeping and you've got to wake him up. So the prophets prayed louder and cut themselves with knives and daggers, right? This is what people who believe in, like, the occult, this is what they do to, like, invoke spirits and stuff like that. Or maybe he's sleeping and you've got to wake him up. So the prophets prayed louder and cut themselves with knives and daggers according to their ritual. Okay, you guys hear that? According to their ritual. Until blood flowed. They kept on ranting and raving until the middle of the afternoon, but no answer came, not a sound was heard, right? Because they were literally serving false gods, right? Then Elijah said to the people, come closer to me. And they all gathered around him. He set about repairing the altars of the Lord, which had been torn down. He took 12 stones, one for each of the 12 tribes of Israel, of the sons of Jacob, the man whom the Lord had given the name Israel. With those stones, he rebuilt the altar for the worship of the Lord. He dug a trench. Okay, so I'm going to skip down. At the hour of the noon sacrifice, I'm in verse 36, the prophet Elijah approached the altar and prayed, O Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, prove now that you are the God of Israel and that I am your servant and have done all this at your command. Answer me, Lord, answer me, so that this people will know that you, the Lord, are God and that you are bringing them back to yourself, right? So God was really doing this miracle, performing this miracle, so that people will know that he is God and that he would draw people back to himself, right? Because God is the only God. Like, there's no other God. Yeah, there's really no other God, right? God is the only God. And Elijah was like, let the God who answers by fire, let him be God. Okay, so if Baal is God, then let him answer by fire. We're going to worship him. If God is God, let him answer by fire and we're going to worship him. Whichever God answers by fire, we're going to worship him. And God, the Almighty God, is the only one that answered by fire. So, you know, anyway, I'm taking you guys through the story, but, you know, I'm going to get to the main course, okay, in a minute. All right. The Lord sent fire down and burnt it up, the sacrifice, the wood, and the stones. And verse 39, when the people saw this, they threw themselves to the ground and exclaimed, the Lord is God, the Lord alone is God. Okay, Elisha ordered, seize the prophets of Baal, don't let any of them get away. And all of them, they were put to death, okay? They were put to death for leading people astray into idol worship and stuff like that. So, in this part now, this is the part the Lord's been speaking to me, okay? Here's what he wants y'all to know, all right? So this is a video, like, specifically for those of you who have been waiting on God for something, or, I mean, this is the kind of revelation I received as I was, you know, being ministered to. So Elijah, there was actually a drought in the land, and the Lord was, you know, Elijah was saying, you know, that there's going to be, you know, I hear the sound of the abundance of rain, right? I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. It's getting ready to rain in some of your lives. Okay. I did not plan that. That just came up. It's getting ready to rain in your life, okay? Rain, and not just any kind of rain. Rain of blessings, okay? Rain of blessings, right? So Elijah ordered his servant, go to King Ahab and tell him to get into his chariot and to go back home before the rain stops him, right? In a little while, the sky was covered with dark clouds and the wind began to blow and heavy rains began to fall. Heavy rains, not light rains, heavy rains began to fall, okay? Ahab got into his chariot and started back to Jezreel. Verse 46 is the verse that I'm going to be talking on today, okay? It says, the power of the Lord came on Elijah. He fastened his clothes round his waist and ran ahead of Ahab all the way to Jezreel. Y'all, here's the revelation I got. Y'all know the Bible talks about the armor of God, right? This is what the Lord is ministering to me. Yeah, it's for other people as well, because we're all going through the same things, most of us, okay, in the body of Christ. Right, we're at different levels, but some of us are on the same level as well. All right, so the Lord was like, Elijah fastened his belt. Okay, so at that time they wore, like, you know, loins and stuff like that. So, or cloth. You guys know. Maybe I'll put a picture here. They wore like those kind of stuff, and so Elijah fastened it. And the Lord was saying to me that that's your belt of truth, right? My word. What did I say to you? What have I said to you? Fasten your belt of truth, knowing what I said, and get ready to run, outrun chariots. Yay. Y'all are getting ready to outrun chariots. There's a scripture that's coming to mind. It says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. How was Elijah? You might not know, but Elijah outrun the chariot. He got to the place that Ahab was going before Ahab, and he ran on his foot, by foot, okay? So, you guys, this is the revelation. God has told you something. He's given you a word or told you, you know, something that he wants you to do, and he's saying, fasten that belt of truth, okay, and get ready to run. Get ready to outrun chariots, okay? The blessings are coming in. It is time to get moving. It is time to get moving. I don't know who this video is for, but you know who it is. Take it back to God if he's talking to you. If anything I said,
you will know if this is your word, by the way.
You will know. You will know. It'll just come alive, all right? So, the power of the Lord is about to come on somebody, okay? The power of the Lord is about to come on someone of you. And you, all you need to do is fasten that belt of truth. Fasten what the Lord has said. Hold tight to what God has said to you and get ready to run, okay? Outrun chariots. So, I think that is all for this video. You're getting ready to outrun chariots. So, thank you guys for watching this video. Ensure that you subscribe, and I have some more videos to be posting. So, until then, bye guys.